Here in Thousand Oaks, California, Kathleen Delaney led a team of conservation biologists on a mission to evaluate the communities of reptiles and amphibians in habitat patches of varying sizes. This map labels the core, large, and small patches of habitat, as well as the locations of the trap arrays used to capture the reptiles. Let's take a closer look at these traps. Each array was formed from 7 buckets arranged in a Y pattern, linked by fabric mesh to guide the reptiles into the traps. Double funnel snake traps were placed along this fence as well. Lizards have a hard time scaling the buckets, and snakes struggle to find the funnel exits. Trapping reptiles like this is a lot easier and less laborious than scouring the land and chasing them yourself. By recording the abundance of each species captured, Delaney's team could calculate the diversity of the reptile community in each patch and compare them. Diversity is a factor of how many species are in an area and how evenly each species is represented. High diversity indicates a healthy community, while low diversity, from low numbers of species or a few species dominating the rest, indicates a disturbed community. Here we can see that the diversity of most of the small patches is similar to that of the large patches, which is a good sign that micro-reserves are useful. But one statistic can't tell us everything. Going back to our map, it's pretty obvious that the large and core patches are less isolated from each other than the small patches. While the small patches have more even communities, they are vulnerable to disturbances that can locally wipe out species. This means that larger habitat patches will preserve more species. Overall, Delaney's team has shown that even though core and large habitat patches are ideal, small patches surrounded by an urban environment are still capable of preserving diverse communities of reptiles and amphibians. But while calculated diversity can be high, some species will be lost in these small patches.